Welcome to FoxLearn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a setup file in Visual Studio 2019 with SQL Local Database using ClickOnce Deployment. To play the demo, you should create a new Windows Forms application, then add the service-based database to your project. Next, you need to connect to the local database from the Visual Studio, then add a simple customer table to the local database. You need to add new data sources to your project, then enter the connection string name and select the table you want to add to your dataset. After you have defined a data type as a data source in a project, you can create forms that display model data by dragging items from the data sources window into your WinForm. These items become controls on the form that are bound to the data source. As you can see, the binding source component will automatically add to your form when dragging items from the data source window into your form. The binding source component serves two purposes. First, it provides a layer of indirection when binding the controls on a form to data. This is accomplished by binding the binding source component to your data source, and then binding the controls on your form to the binding source component. All further interaction with the data, including navigating, sorting, filtering, and updating, is accomplished with calls to the binding source component. Second, the binding source component can act as a strongly typed data source. You can easily modify your layout after dragging items from the data source window into your WinForm. You can add check changed event handlers to the gender checkbox control allows you to change text to male or female based on gender value. To fix the error, you need to open the data set. Next, set the automatic increase value for the ID field. You can find your local database in the debug folder. Remember that each time you rebuild your project, all data in the debug folder will be deleted. To create a ClickOnce deployment, you need to create a test certificate. Signing the manifests ensures that no one can tamper with your deployment and download it to another computer in place of yours. You need to select the folder you want to publish, or you can enter your FTP account to publish your application to the FTP server. Next, enter the URL that you will provide when you deploy the application. Select the application should check for updates checkbox, and then click before the application starts radio button. This will enable automatic updates. You should enter the URL that you want to download your application update. As you can see, our database automatically adds to the list of installed files. you should install all prerequisites on your client machine. When you actually deploy your application to a customer, you will have to select the appropriate version of the .NET framework and Windows installer, plus any other prerequisites you need. The prerequisites are installed the first time the user runs the application setup program. At a minimum, you must complete the product name and publisher name. In the product name text box, type the name of the application shortcut. In the publisher name text box, type the name of the folder that will be listed on the Windows Start menu. In the suite name text box, type the name of the subfolder that will appear under the publisher name. You can also specify a support URL and an error URL that users can go to if they experience installation problems. Click the Manifests item, and then select the Create Desktop shortcut checkbox. When the user installs the application, it will create a desktop shortcut in addition to the shortcut on the Start menu. You need to enter your FTP account to publish your application to the FTP server. Right-click on your project, then select Open Folder and File Explorer from the menu, then you can find your setup file in the Debug folder. Thank you for watching this video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.